जननी जन्मभूमिश्च स्वर्गादपि गरीयसी।
Welcome to Sagarmatha Television. Sagarmatha is the Nepali name for Mount Everest, the highest mountain of the world. It is also known as the rooftop of the world. Sagarmatha Television is the first Nepali television program ever to be produced and broadcasted outside of Nepal. Sagarmatha Television will show you the beauty of Nepal and its culture. Namaste. This is Shritika the Hall, your host for today's program. And now, as always, before we get started, we would like to thank our generous underwriters for making Sagarmatha Television possible in part. Welcome back to the program. As you all know, the first segment of our show is Bibit Sangalo. This includes national songs, news from Nepal and the Nepalese living around the world, community activities, immigration tips, entertainment, and much more. Now we like to begin today's episode of Sagarmatha Television with Bibit Sangalo, presented by our producer, Mr. Ram Chandra Karel.
नेपाल अहिले अपाङ्ग भयो चारैतिरको त्यो बन्दले मातृभूमि नेपाललाई कहिले छाड्ने द्वन्द्वले नेता भनौँदा भाषण गर्छन् कार्यकर्ता त्यसैमा ठिक्क गरिब गुरुवा जनताहरू भएरे साह्रै दिक्क नेपाल भयो अस्तव्यस्त विकासको कुरै छैन त्यस्तो देश अहिले लथालिङ्ग भयो सप्रिने हो कि होइन ठुला पार्टीहरू भागभन्डामा साना रमिता हेर्ने यस्तै भए जनताले चाहिँ कहिले शान्तिको सास फेर्ने यस्तै भए नेपालले कहिले शान्तिको सास फेर्ने नेपालप्रति आफ्नो चिन्ताका यी केही हरफहरूसहित आजको विविध सङ्गालो कार्यक्रमबाट म सञ्चालक रामचन्द्र खरेलको नमस्कार आदरणीय दर्शकवृन्द आज सेप्टेम्बर 6 तारिक इस्वी सम्म 2015 तदनुसार विक्रम सम्म 2072 साल भाद्र 20 गते आइतबार नवमी तिथि अब यहाँहरूलाई स्वागत छ आजको यो विविध सङ्गालो कार्यक्रममा आदरणीय दर्शकबिन हिजो हिन्दूहरूको महान चाड कृष्ण जन्माष्टमी परेको हुँदा सर्वप्रथम हामी हाम्रा सम्पूर्ण दर्शक महानुभावहरूमा कृष्ण जन्माष्टमीको हार्दिक मङ्गलमय शुभकामना व्यक्त गर्दै अब हामी आजको यो विविध सङ्गालो कार्यक्रम सुरु गर्न चाहन्छौँ यो एउटा नेपाली भजनबाट यो थियो सगरमाथा टेलिभिजनका नेपाल प्रतिनिधि सरिता लामिछानेबाट प्राप्त एउटा नेपाली भजन आदरणीय दर्शकबिन सगरमाथा टेलिभिजन नेपालको इतिहासमा विदेशमा चलेको सबैभन्दा पहिलो नेपाली टेलिभिजन कार्यक्रम हो सगरमाथा टेलिभिजन स्पी सम्मत 1996 वर्ल्ड भ्यू टेलिभिजनमा सुरु भई अहिले एमएसजी नेटवर्क्सबाट डिसी क्षेत्रमा नियमित रूपमा प्रसारण भइरहेको छ जुन सेटेलाइट मार्फत अमेरिकाभरि र वेबसाइट मार्फत संसारभरिका दर्शकहरू सामु पुगेको छ
नेपाल
यो थियो हाम्रो दोस्रो प्रस्तुति नेपाल दर्शन टेलिभिजनको एक झलक। नेपाल दर्शन टेलिभिजन अहिले हरेक आइतबार दिउँसो 1:30 बजे अर्थात् यो कार्यक्रमको लगत्तैपछि यही एमएजी नेटवर्क्समा प्रसारण हुँदैछ। आशा छ यहाँहरूले अवश्य छुटाउनुहुने छैन। नेपाल दर्शन टेलिभिजनको मुख्य उद्देश्य हो नेपालको परिचय विदेशीहरूलाई दिई उनीहरूलाई नेपाल घुम्न आकर्षण गर्नु अर्थात् नेपालको पर्यटन प्रवर्धनमा सहयोग पुर्याउनु। आदरणीय दर्शकबिन, यही अगस्त 29 तारिक शनिबारका दिन अमेरिकन सोसाइटी अफ नेपलिज इन्जिनियर्स तथा कम्प्युटर एसोसिएसन अफ युएसएले आफ्नो संस्थाको वार्षिक सम्मेलन न्युजर्सीमा सम्पन्न गरेको थियो। त अब प्रस्तुत छ उक्त कार्यक्रम सम्बन्धी एक रिपोर्ट।
गत अगस्त 29 तारिक शनिबारका दिन अमेरिकन सोसाइटी अफ नेपलिज इन्जिनियर्स तथा कम्प्युटर एसोसिएसन अफ नेपाल युएसएले आफ्नो संस्थाको वार्षिक सम्मेलन न्युजर्सीमा सम्पन्न गरेको थियो। उक्त कार्यक्रमको उद्घाटन सत्रका विशेष अतिथिहरूमा अमेरिकाका लागि नेपाली राजदूत महामहिम डाक्टर अर्जुन कार्की, संयुक्त राष्ट्रसङ्घका लागि नेपाली स्थायी प्रतिनिधि महामहिम ज्ञानचन्द्र आचार्य, नेपाल इन्जिनियर्स एसोसिएसनका अध्यक्ष ध्रुव कुमार थापा हुनुहुन्थ्यो।
So I would like to be the first person to welcome all of you to the 8th American Society of Nepalese Engineers and Computer Association of USA joint conference. We've been having several years now, this conference, 8th, as you see from the title. Just to introduce myself, I'm Ramesh Malla. I'm a faculty at the University of Connecticut in Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering. And I had the honor of being the founding president of the American Society of Nepalese Engineers. It's been my pleasure to have many of the colleagues coming together and doing this program.
Society of Nepalese Engineers ka sansthapak adhyaksha Dr. Ramesh Malla dwara sanchalan gariyeko ukta karyakram ma संस्थाका वर्तमान अध्यक्ष डाक्टर राजेन्द्र कुमार श्रेष्ठले टेलिफोनद्वारा सम्मेलनको शुभकामना दिनुभएको थियो।
I would like to take this opportunity to give a special welcome to our distinguished speakers, Ambassador Dr. Karki, UN Undersecretary General Mr. Acharya, and Nepal Engineers Association President Engineer Thapa. Thank you all for taking the time off your busy schedule to participate in this conference.
त्यसै गरी अर्का वक्ता कम्प्युटर एसोसिएसन अफ नेपाल युएसए का अध्यक्ष प्रदीप खनालले सम्मेलनको बारेमा जानकारी दिनुभएको थियो।
Knowledge sharing and networking are keys to professional development and collective professional development is key to uplifting of the society. With the ever increasing number of professionals of Nepali origin all over the world, bringing together like-minded people in one big platform to share their knowledge and experience is very crucial. Today, here at this conference, we are doing just that. It is estimated that about 1 million people of Nepali origin live in countries outside of Nepal. In the US alone, about 12,000 Nepali students are currently enrolled in different universities to pursue degrees in different areas, including engineering and science, business and management, life and social sciences. Every year, thousands of such Nepali students graduate from the universities in US and elsewhere in the world.
उक्त अवसरमा सम्मेलनका स्थानीय आयोजक डाक्टर उपेन्द्र कर्णले सम्मेलनमा सबैलाई स्वागत गर्नुभएको थियो।
Due to the recent earthquake, devastating earthquake in Nepal, this program we decided to have our conference dedicated to earthquake related topics. We have a lot of exciting topics related with earthquakes and I hope that this will be very knowledgeable to all of us to share our knowledge and update our knowledge for the science and technology and appreciate the contribution of our scientists and engineers from Nepal who are here in the United States to do their best to their country and see what the best they can do.
कार्यक्रममा डाक्टर रमेश मल्लले उक्त सम्मेलनको बारेमा विस्तृत जानकारी दिनुभएको थियो। सोही अवसरमा विशेष अतिथि अमेरिकाका लागि नेपाली राजदूत महामहिम डाक्टर अर्जुन कार्कीले सम्मेलनको सफलताको कामना गर्दै संस्थाले नेपालमा गर्नुपर्ने कामहरूको बारेमा जानकारी दिनुभएको थियो।
And I appreciate your future plan for providing assistance in the reconstruction efforts and earthquake disaster management related education in Nepal and hope that it can be one of the main focuses of reconstruction process. It has to be noted that there is a need for serious attention that need to be directed towards providing technological support in post-earthquake Nepal, particularly for the planning of settlement, clustering, zoning, and designing of residential housing and school. It is important, even though some efforts are underway with the assistance of development partners, for you as Nepalese to be familiar with the appropriate and required technology that are especially important to the recovery of development and least developed countries that have been hit by a natural disaster in recent years. Something that could be mutually beneficial would be a close relationship and cooperation with the Nepal Reconstruction Authority in its effort to rebuild Nepal, especially regarding suitable technology and exporting. The Embassy of Nepal in USA is willing to support or even coordinate building a network of individuals and organizations that are seeking to help not only to reconstruct but also building back better Nepal too.
त्यसै गरी संयुक्त राष्ट्रसङ्घका लागि नेपाली स्थायी प्रतिनिधि महामहिम ज्ञानचन्द्र आचार्यले अहिले देखिएका समस्या र त्यसका समाधानका बारेमा स्पष्ट खाका प्रस्तुत गर्नुभएको थियो।
I think I greatly admire and appreciate your love for Nepal as well as your solid and dedicated contributions not only to help Nepal but also to promote the transfer of technology via forum and provide the research and the the technical assistance to the Nepal. My topic today here is about the earthquake in 2015 in Nepal and building back better with global partnership. I think this is a very important topic when you look at the activities that you are engaged in. And this is so pertinent that we are meeting just after the a major conference, the international conference that government of Nepal organized together with the support of the international community. We all know that the exact timing of many of the natural disasters are unpredictable. But what we also know is that better preparation will limit the damage and will help build stronger resilience afterwards. I think it is with that objective in mind that the topic of the building better has a very strong relevance to all of us and especially to the engineers because you are in the forefront in terms of really building back better. Now why I say that, I think it is very clear that when you look at the damages, I'm told I'm not an expert on the earthquake, but I'm told that this is the natural disaster which doesn't kill anybody, it is the structure that kills the large number, unlike the floods, unlike the other things. So we have to really focus on the structures because that is the biggest killer in any earthquake. So that has to be the central focus of our building back better. Now, again, when you look at the destruction in Nepal, of course, we all know it. Over half a million houses were destroyed, major cultural and the historical monuments were destroyed, major infrastructure were destroyed, schools and the hospitals were destroyed or damaged. And that shows that building back better will have to really focus on
definitely
the physical infrastructure. But also the livelihood of the people. How to really make sure that when the physical infrastructure is built around there, that the livelihood of the people are being really taken care of. So it has to be really linked with the infrastructure, the community, and the people. I think this is a message that I think we received when we had the international conference organized in Nepal.
त्यसै गरी अर्का अतिथि नेपाल इन्जिनियर्स एसोसिएसनका अध्यक्ष ध्रुवराज थापाले आफूलाई नेपालबाट उक्त कार्यक्रममा निमन्त्रणा गरेकोमा आयोजक वर्गलाई धन्यवाद दिँदै भूकम्पपछि नेपालको पुनर्निर्माणमा सहभागी हुन सबैलाई आह्वान गर्नुभएको थियो।
छैन
engineering, science and technology lai atyanta pachhari pariyeko cha jaba samma yo kura lai agadi lyaidaina taba samma hamile jati sukai divasata dekhe pani rati sapna dekhe pani desle agragami dishama chai ekdam drutta gatima hidna sakdaina deshma infrastructure development hun sakdaina jaba samma deshma infrastructure development hudaina taba samma deshma aarthik उन्नति हुन सक्दैन जबसम्म आर्थिक उन्नति हुन सक्दैन तबसम्म राजनीतिक स्थिरता पनि आउन सक्दैन र जबसम्म राजनीतिक स्थिरता आउन सक्दैन तबसम्म शान्ति पनि हुन सक्दैन भन्ने हामीले भन्याएका छौँ मलाई लाग्छ यसमा सम्पूर्ण साथीहरूले यहाँ बसे पनि त्यो कुरालाई राम्रोसँग रियलाइज गर्न सक्नुहुन्छ र यही नै आजको विश्वको तथ्य हो जस्तो मलाई लाग्दछ तपाईँहरूको यो प्रयासले यहाँबाट निस्किएका कन्क्लुजनहरू नेपालमा पनि पठाइदिनु भयो हामीले के गर्नुपर्छ कसो गर्नुपर्छ भन्ने कुरा अलिकति चाहिँ नि भनिदिनु भयो भने सायद नेपालले पनि नेपालमा भएका गैर प्राकृतिक व्यक्तित्वहरू गैर इन्जिनियरहरू अथवा गैर साइन्टिस्टहरूमा पनि यो कुरा हामीले दिमागमा पार्न सक्यौँ भने अनि बल्ल इन्जिनियरिङ साइन्स र टेक्नोलोजीले केही प्राथमिकता पाउनेछ र जसरी अहिले नेपालले उद्देश्य राखेको छ सन् 2022 लिस्ट डेभलप कन्ट्रीबाट अन्डर डेभलपिङ कन्ट्रीमा जाने भन्ने जुन लक्ष्य राखेको छ त्यो लक्ष्य पुरा हुन सक्छ भन्ने कुरा भन्न सकिन्छ त्यस कारणले यहाँ बस्ने नेपाली दाजुभाइ दिदीबहिनीहरूले विभिन्न समयमा आफ्ना साथीभाइहरू अझ भन्दा पनि विभिन्न समयमा मैले थाहा भएसम्म विभिन्न पार्टीका नेताहरू पनि यहाँ भिजिट गरिरहनुहुन्छ यहाँहरूसँग भेटघाट भइरहन्छ ओभर द फोन कुरा भइरहन्छ त्यो कुरा गर्दाखेरि के हो यो देशले कसरी विकास गरेको छ नेपालमा के गर्नुपर्छ भन्ने कुरा त्यस्तो किसिमले चाहिँ भनिदिनु भयो भनेदेखि यहाँले आफ्नो चाहिँ अनुभवहरू सेयर गरिदिनु भयो भने र एकदमै कुनै पनि आफ्नो स्वार्थ नराखिकन यस्ता कुराहरू उहाँहरूलाई चाहिँ फिडब्याक दिनुभयो भने यसले पक्कै पनि केही सकारात्मक रूप लिन्छ होला र केही चाहिँ देशलाई अगाडि बढ्नलाई मद्दत गर्छ होला भन्ने मेरो चाहिँ भनाइ छ
सोही अवसरमा गैर आवासीय नेपाली सङ्घ अन्तर्राष्ट्रिय समन्वय परिषदका सल्लाहकार तथा विधान समितिका को चेयर रामचन्द्र खरेलले सम्मेलनको सफलताको कामना गर्दै सबै इन्जिनियरहरूलाई एनआरएनएमा आबद्ध भई नेपाललाई सहयोग गर्न अनुरोध गर्नुभएको थियो
तपाईँहरू सबै इन्जिनियरहरूसँग मिलेर गैर आवासीय नेपाली सङ्घले पनि अगाडि बढ्ने जम्मको गरेको छ त्यहाँ पैसाले मात्रै अथवा बोलेर मात्रै नहुनेछ इन्जिनियरहरूको जरुरी छ तपाईँहरू जस्तो मान्छेको खाँचो छ नेपाललाई
उद्घाटन सत्रको अन्त्यमा आयोजकका तर्फबाट ठाकुर ढकालले अतिथिहरू प्रायोजक तथा स्वयंसेवकहरूलाई धन्यवाद दिनुभएको थियो
On behalf of American Society of Nepalese Engineers and CAN USA and the entire engineering, scientific and technological community here together in New York, New Jersey area and on my own behalf, I would like to extend very heartily word of thanks to all guests, speakers and all of you.
उक्त कार्यक्रममा विभिन्न फोरमहरूको समेत आयोजना गरिएको थियो भने त्यहाँ उपस्थित व्यक्तित्वहरूले आआफ्ना जिज्ञासा समेत राख्नु भएको थियो
इन द लाइट अफ द लार्ज नम्बर अफ द इन्टरनेसनल कम्युनिटिज हु ह्याभ एक्चुअली प्लेस्ड देयर सपोर्ट फर द रिकन्स्ट्रक्सन अफ नेपाल आई थिङ्क वी सुड बी माइन्डफुल अफ द फ्याक्ट वाट ह्याप अफ द फ्याक्ट स्पेसली द्याट ह्यापन इन हाइटी You know, what is the exact modality and the mechanism of the international community, you know, they are going to be involved in the reconstruction process of Nepal?
I agree with you, but I think, can you maybe give us some highlight as to the possible realities of really making this work in Nepal?
Well, okay, let's see what Nepal has done so far, okay? And what has been already done and what we could do. So that triggered us to publish this earthquake preparedness petition paper book.
What's the coincidence, why the earthquake cycle repeats in every 75 years and how can it be the same for Nepal as well as for Japan? It's just like some certain geological process that's very similar.
And along with that, this year we actually applied for this community service grant at our school. So they offered this $3,000 grant to anyone who wanted to use it in a wise way.
Do you think
the construction material in Nepal, cement, sand, and bricks. Are they good enough to go for that height of the building with no FAR, no open space, no evacuation plan? If so, have you thought of any alternative way how Kathmandu can rehabilitate now?
We do have the materials, we do have the technology that we can effectively design. The lacking in the system is for the implementation.
There were 300 aftershocks, which are greater than 4 in magnitude. And the epicenter was Borka, and for the another earthquake, it was in Dolaka here. So.
कार्यक्रमको अन्त्यमा कार्यक्रमका स्थानीय आयोजक डाक्टर उपेन्द्र कर्णले भन्नुभयो
For this conference, I've been associated from the American Society of Nepalese Engineers from the beginning. After drafting the steering committees and drafting the bylaws and other things, and then at this present time, I'm serving as General Secretary for this organization. And this year, I was given the responsibility to organize this conference here in the New York area. So this was a great challenge, but this is a great opportunity in the sense because this year's conference we decided to dedicate our earthquake related topics because due to the recent earthquake that happened in Nepal, this is very urgent that we communicate the engineers and scientists in America what we think about, what the best we could do, and how we can serve better to Nepal and how we can communicate our understanding and knowledge and that can be used to make a better Nepal. And I would like to thank on behalf of this American Society of Nepalese Engineers and Can USA conference to thank you to Sagarmatha TV to coming here and providing the support and coverage for this event.
सोही अवसरमा नेपालमा गएको भूकम्पको बेला सहयोग गर्ने कक्षा 11मा अध्ययनरत युवा 16 वर्षीय उदिति कर्णले आफ्ना प्रोजेक्टको बारेमा जानकारी दिनुभएको थियो
My name is Aditi Karna. I'm a rising senior at Princeton Day School. Last year I came up with an organization with my friend Malavika called Made for Aid. We essentially collect student donated artwork and we sell it for a greater cause. So this year, after the earthquake, we have spent some time in Chennai as well as Nepal, but mainly Nepal because of the devastating earthquake. So the two major things we did, one was in Bhaktapur and the other thing was in Nepal. So in Bhaktapur, while we were there, we actually physically walked around the city to see who was there, what their stories were, and how we could help. So we actually met a woman, and she was struggling to pay her boy's tuition because her husband had gone into hiding and after the earthquake, and she was basically only the only one raising money to send her kids to school. So we decided to pay her kids' tuition, and then along with that, we also paid a few other kids' tuition just because these kids who were left with nothing were about to drop out of school. So in Bhaktapur, we did some of that. We also teamed up with an organization there called Archery Nepal. So they're located in Ward Number 10, also known as Tulabiasi. And they essentially set up these tents after the earthquake by selling their artwork afterwards. That's how they raised the money to set up these tents. So we teamed up with them, and we were able to document some of their work, which is what they really needed. They wanted to show what they were doing. So since I am a photographer and my friend she does media art, videography, we were able to help them document their work as well. We were also able to donate art supplies for their art workshop, see the kids, because they need some sort of therapy, some time to express their feelings. Every Saturday they have this art workshop, so we were able to donate some art supplies to them. There's also a women's empowerment workshop, and we were able to help out with that.
So what is your message to the younger generation, what they can do?
Actually, I want to mention the bigger project that we did. So in Sindhupalchok, I'll make this more brief, but while we were in Sindhupalchok, we were able to construct 6 homes there. And these homes were not just for any village family that's been displaced. They're actually for Dalits, and because the funds that have been going to the area after the earthquake have not been distributed to the Dalits. So we decided to build these 6 homes just for them. And also in the same area, we decided to build a school.
which is still under construction. But those are the two main things I did in Pakistan and Nepal trip. I mean, when you're here, you don't really realize like how damaging the earthquake is. You just hear, you know, it destructed everything. But when you go there, you can actually see what people are going through. Mm-hmm. And you can see how strong they are. I found that the Nepali people that have been the most hurt by the earthquake are very, very strong people. They have not let their smiles go away. They have not let anything put them down. They're actually just working to try to get a better life. They're working to help themselves out, help their community out. And it was really inspiring for us, because if anything like that happened here, obviously we have some better resources, but we would never understand what it's like to go through the same kind of pain, to lose your home, to lose everything. And I can't emphasize that enough, really. The amount of perseverance they all have is incredible. I will request everyone younger than me, older than me, whatever, to actually figure out, do some research and figure out how you can donate. Because the cost of living in Nepal is much cheaper than it is here. And that's why school tuition is a lot cheaper, building homes is a lot cheaper. There are many things that you can do that you wouldn't think you could do for such an affordable price. So it's very easy to make an impact there if you get in contact with the right people. You can do a lot of great things there. So I suggest everyone to go out and do whatever they can.
अहिले यहाँहरू हेर्दै हुनुहुन्थ्यो अमेरिकन सोसाइटी अफ नेपलिज इन्जिनियर्स तथा कम्प्युटर एसोसिएसन अफ नेपाल युएसएले आयोजना गरेको एक कार्यक्रम. आदरणीय दर्शकबिन, यहाँहरूलाई थाहै छ कि सगरमाथा टेलिभिजनको मुख्य उद्देश्य हो नेपाली समुदायमा सेवा पुर्याउनु, जसमा हामीले ट्याक्स सम्बन्धी जानकारी, कानुनी परामर्श, मेडिकल टिप्स, धार्मिक जानकारी तथा अन्य कार्यक्रमहरू प्रस्तुत गर्दै आएका छौँ. त्यसै अनुरूप अब पालु छ कानुनी परामर्शको, जसलाई प्रस्तुत गर्दै हुनुहुन्छ कानुनविद वन्दिता दाहाल.
नमस्कार. सगरमाथा टेलिभिजन हेर्नुहुने समस्त दर्शकवृन्दमा म दाहाल एन्ड एसोसिएट्सका तर्फबाट इमिग्रेसन अटर्नी वन्दिता दाहालको हार्दिक अभिवादन. सधैँ चाहिँ यहाँहरूलाई इमिग्रेसन सम्बन्धी केही जानकारीमूलक कार्यक्रम लिएर म यहाँको सामु उपस्थित भएकी छु. र आजको विषय हाम्रो नेपाली कम्युनिटीमा अत्याधिक चर्चित अहिलेको विषय, जुन कि टिपिएस, टेम्पोररी प्रोटेक्टेड स्ट्याटस. हुन त हामीले टिपिएसको बारेमा विभिन्न प्रोग्रामहरूमा भन्दै आएका छौँ, र आजको मैले फोकस केमा गर्नु छ भने टिपिएस र वर्क पर्मिट. धेरैजना विभिन्न स्ट्याटसका व्यक्तिहरूले अहिले टिपिएस भर्नुभएको छ. जस्तो धेरैजना भनौँ, कतिजना टुरिस्ट भिजामा रहनुभएका, कतिजना टुरिस्ट भिजामा आएर आउट अफ स्ट्याटस हुनुभएका, कतिजना हुनुहुन्छ स्टुडेन्ट भिजाको, कतिजना चाहिँ असाइलम पेन्डिङ भएकामा व्यक्तिहरूले पनि टिपिएस भर्नुभएको छ. र टिपिएस भर्दाखेरि टिपिएसको प्याकेजमा हामीले चाहिँ युजुअली सबैलाई रेकमेन्ड पहिला पनि गरिसकेका छौँ. एउटा फर्म हुन्छ I-812 भन्ने फर्म, र त्यो सँगसँगै वर्क परमिटको 765 पनि भर्नुपर्छ भनेर. तर जो व्यक्तिलाई वर्क परमिटको जरुरत छैन, उहाँहरूले चाहिँ मलाई वर्क परमिट चाहिँदैन भनेर मेन्सन गर्नुपर्ने हुन्छ, तर वर्क परमिटको फर्म चाहिँ सब्मिट गर्नुपर्ने हुन्छ. अब टिपिएसमा युएससिआइएसको फाइलिङ फी 515 रेगुलर केसेसमा हो भने, जो व्यक्तिले चाहिँ वर्क परमिट माग्नुहुन्न उहाँहरूलाई चाहिँ 135 पे गर्न सकिन्छ. र यदि वर्क पर्मिट नजा कतिजनाले चाहिँ यसैमा के कन्फ्युज हुनुभएको छ भने, मलाई वर्क पर्मिट चाहिँदैन र म त मैले किन सब्मिट गर्नुपर्छ, त्यो चाहिँ कस्तो भन्दा युएससिआइएसको रिक्वायरमेन्ट अनुसार उनीहरूले फिङ्गर प्रिन्टिङ गर्नको लागि अथवा रेकर्ड किपिङको लागि, यो व्यक्तिको वर्क पर्मिट छ कि छैन भन्ने इजको लागि पनि उनीहरूले, त्यो चाहिँ रिक्वायर्ड डकुमेन्ट हो. र कतिजना व्यक्तिहरू जो विथहोल्डिङ अफ रिमुभलमा हुनुहुन्छ, विथहोल्डिङ अफ रिमुभल भनेको चाहिँ कस्तो हुन्छ भन्दाखेरि, उनीहरूलाई अमेरिकामा बस्ने अनुमति त दिइन्छ, यहाँ बस्न र काम गर्न अनुमति दिइन्छ, तर अमेरिकाभन्दा बाहिर जान दिइँदैन. उहाँहरूले चाहिँ टिपिएस भरौँ कि नभरौँ भन्ने कन्फ्युजन छ. उहाँहरूको पक्षमा चाहिँ टिपिएस भरेर एकदमै धेरै ठुलो चेन्ज र धेरै ठुलो फाइदा हुने होइन, किनभने दे आर अलरेडी अलाउड टु स्टे हियर, दे आर अलरेडी अलाउड टु वर्क, होइन. उहाँहरूको फेरि वर्क पर्मिट पनि कस्तो छ भने, विथहोल्डिङ अफ रिमुभल भएको व्यक्तिको चाहिँ सधैँभरि वर्क पर्मिट चाहिँ फ्री नै आइरहेको हुन्छ. जस्तो असाइलम फाइल गर्ने व्यक्तिको पहिलो पटक वर्क पर्मिट फ्री आउँछ भने, विथहोल्डिङ अफ रिमुभलबाट चाहिँ एज लङ एज दे आर हियर उहाँहरूको वर्क पर्मिट फ्री नै हुन्छ. सो TPS file garna parne jaruri ke ho ra TPS file garera waharlai chai ke impact parcha ki pardaina bhandakeri waharlai recommendation chai TPS file garera pani travel document apply garna ko lagi recommend garieko chaina kinabhan travel doc waharlai ta wahar ko status protected as long as they are staying here haina tara travel document liera bahira gaera auna ta paincha tara jab TPS sakincha TPS sakepachi ko status ke huncha so if there is any alternative way jasto withholding of removal le kina dincha ta kunai pani byakti lai bhanda keri wahar ko case haru nai haina jasto wahar le asylum ko lagi file garnu bhayo asylum ko lagi eligible hunu bhayena kina hunu bhayena either ek barsha pachi aako ek barsha pachi file garnu bhayo अथवा उहाँहरुको मल्टिपल एन्ट्री थियो हैन त्यो मल्टिपल पहिलो चोटि आएर पनि एन्ट्री विदाउट इन्स्पेक्सन र पछिपछि पनि आउनु भयो भने उहाँहरु असाइलम को लागि एलिजिबल हुँदैन त्यस्तो व्यक्तिले चाहिँ यदि ट्राभल डकुमेन्ट लिएर म बाहिर गएर म फेरि आउँछु र मैले अरु कुनै प्रोसेसहरु अरु कुनै प्रावधानहरु जस्तो रि असाइलम फाइल गर्नुहुन्छ कि अरु कुनै गर्नको लागि मिल्छ कि भनेर पनि ट्राई गर्नु भएको छ तर यही बस्ने हो भने चाहिँ उहाँहरुलाई टीपीएस फाइल गर्दाखेरि धेरै ठूलो इम्प्याक्ट चाहिँ पर्दैन र यति भन्दै आज यो आजको विषयलाई म यही सक्छु र पछि फेरि यहाँहरुलाई टीपीएस असाइलम अथवा विथहोल्डिङ अफ रिमूभल यस्तै कुनै जानकारी चाहिएमा यहाँहरुले सगरमाथा टेलिभिजनको मार्फत मलाई सम्पर्क गर्न सक्नुहुन्छ आजलाई यति नै थ्याङ्क यू Thank you.
Sagarmatha Television.
Namaste, I'm Lisa. You're watching Sagarmatha Television.
अमेरिका नेपाल ओमन्स एसोसिएसन अफ ग्रेटर वासिङटन डिसीद्वारा सञ्चालित निशुल्क स्वास्थ्य शिविरमा डाक्टर महेश्वर वैद्य, आर्यन मन्जु सङ्ग्रौला तथा आर्यन सुनिता श्रेष्ठ सहितको टोलीले निशुल्क स्वास्थ्य सेवा उपलब्ध गराइरहेको हुँदा उक्त सेवाको उपयोग गर्न यस स्क्रिनमा भएका नम्बरहरूमा सम्पर्क गर्नुहोला।
नमस्ते म सरिषा अधिकारी हुनुहुन्छ।
ट्याक्स राजा एकाउन्टिङ म्यानेजमेन्ट एसोसिएट्सका सेवाहरू तीन भिन्न ठाउँमा उपलब्ध छन्।
घर बाहिर घरके स्वाद सम्झनुहोस् घरे कबाब तथा साङ्ग्रेला, फ्रेस सिम्पल तथा अर्ग्यानिक नेपाली तथा इन्डियन खानाहरूको भण्डार, डाइनिङ क्यारिआउटका साथै क्यारिङको समेत व्यवस्था छ। सधैँ सम्झनुहोस् घरे कबाब तथा साङ्ग्रेला। अन्य जानकारीहरूका लागि यस स्क्रिनमा भएका नम्बरहरूमा सम्पर्क गर्नुहोला।
आदरणीय दर्शकबिन, हामी आजको यो विविध सँगालो कार्यक्रमको अन्ततिर आइपुगेका छौँ। दर्शकबिन, सगरमाथा टेलिभिजन तथा नेपाल दर्शन टेलिभिजन तपाईँहरूको सहयोग, सल्लाह, सुझाव तथा प्रतिक्रियाको सधैँ अपेक्षा गर्दछ, जसका लागि हाम्रो ठेगाना हो सगरमाथा टेलिभिजन, पिओ बक्स 1400, लोटन भर्जिनिया 22079। हाम्रो इमेल ठेगाना हो info@nepaltvusa.com। हामीलाई फोन गर्न सक्नुहुनेछ। हाम्रो फोन नम्बर हो 7039269530। हस्त दर्शकबिन, अब यहाँहरू समक्ष नेपाल टुरिज्म बोर्ड काठमाडौँ नेपालबाट प्राप्त नेपालका केही रमणीय दृश्यहरू प्रस्तुत गर्दै आजको यो विविध सँगालो कार्यक्रमबाट म सञ्चालक रामचन्द्र खरेल बिदा चाहन्छु। आगामी कार्यक्रमसम्मका लागि बिदा दिनुहोस्। नमस्ते।
For today. We hope you have enjoyed our program.
Don't forget to watch Nepal Darshan Television right after the show, right here on MHZ Networks. Now we would like to conclude today's episode of Sagarmatha Television with this beautiful Nepali song. Have a great week ahead. See you next time. And until then, this is Shridika Dahal saying goodbye and namaste.